In this video lecture, we are going to see analysis of tank for seismic load. Okay, seismic load ke liye analysis of elevated water tank. So the water tank is supported on 4 RC column, and we will see all the detailed procedure. So let's begin. Welcome to Real Civil YouTube channel. I will first read the question. RC circular water tank, its capacity is 50 m³. Internal diameter is 4.65, height is 3.3 meter. Simultaneously, I will show you the details. So, internal diameter is 4.65 meter. Water height is 3 meter, above which 0.3 meter is the freeboard. Then, supported on RC staging consists of 4 columns of 450 mm diameter. So, the column is circular. Horizontal bracings of 300 by 450 mm at 4 levels, 1, 2, 3, 4, and size is 300 by 450. The lowest supply level is 12 meter above the ground level. Staging confirmed to ductile detailing as per IS 13920. Staging column have isolated rectangular footing at a depth of 2 meter from the ground level. So there is footing at a depth of 2 meter from the ground level. Soil in seismic zone 2, concrete M20 Fe415 density 25 kN per m³. So let's solve this problem step by step. First, I will tell you that tank must be analyzed for tank full and empty condition. Okay, so the preliminary data, that means I have written all the components and their respective sizes. Okay, if you need this, need the notes, you can comment, I will provide you. So the components such as roof slab, I will show you here. Roof slab having thickness 120 mm, walls having thickness, these are the walls, 200 mm, floor slab means the slab here. Then gallery means the extended portion here. Okay, that is having thickness 110, floor beam 250 by 600 mm. So these are the floor beam. Okay, then column 450, bracing 300 by 450 mm. Okay, these are the details. Ye details lagti hai kyunki hume dead load nikalna hai. Okay, so weight calculation, very simple. We will calculate one by one. First, starting from the top, roof slab. We want its weight, dead weight. So it's simple, volume into density, area into thickness, we will get volume. Area, as it is circular, pi by 4 into d square, and here d is 5.05. as we know that internal diameter is 4.65, plus we need to add the wall thickness. Okay, so that we can get the total area. Into thickness of roof slab is 0.12, into density is 25, so we will get 60.1 kN. Now next is dead load of the walls. Okay, so length of wall will be pi into d. Okay, so d is 4.85, into width of the wall is 0.2, and height of the wall is 3.30. okay, I just told you, into 25, so we will get here the dead load of the wall. Then floor slab, similarly circular, hence pi by 4 into d square, that d is 5.05, into thickness of the floor slab is 0.20 into 25. Okay, floor beam, similarly pi d into 0.25 into here, as you can see here, floor beam is this. Okay, but we have calculated floor slab dead load separately, so we need to deduct the depth of the slab, that is 200 mm. Hence I have reduced 0.6 minus 0.2 into 25. Gallery, pi by 4 into total distance is 7.05 square minus up to this distance is 5.05, square. So pi by 4 d square into thickness of the gallery is 0.110 into density of concrete is 25. Okay, next is column. Column area of the column will be pi by 4 into d square. Okay, into the height of the column, which is measured from above the ground level and up to the center of this. You just need to add this. Okay, so you will get 11.7. Such a four columns are there, hence multiply by 4 into 25. Next is the braces. The say length of the length is 3430. That means this is 3430 brace into cross section of bracing is 0.30 into 0.45. Such four braces are present. 1, 2, 3, 4, and these are on the four side. Hence, I have once again multiplied it by 4 into 25. Okay, this will get bracing dead load and the water. So, water will be the inside of this tank. So, this distance we know 4.65. So, pi by 4 d square into height of the water. Water will be up to 3 meter only. Hence, into 3 and into 9.81 waters. Therefore, total we will get 499.8. Okay, this is our first step. Our next step is very simple. We need some calculations like weight of staging. So, weight of staging involves column weight plus bracing weight. So, column weight we have calculated 186.1. and bracing weight 185.2, so together 371.3. Now we need to calculate weight of empty container. So empty container weight include roof slab, means the slab on the top, then walls, then floor slab, floor beam and the gallery. Okay, so you can see here it will involve slab, wall, gallery, then this floor beam and floor slab. Okay, so we have calculated all these dead loads. So you just need to write down as per we calculated. So the value we get 502. Now here we need one thing. We want weight of container plus 1/3 of weight of staging. So weight of container is 502.1 plus 1/3 of weight of staging, means 371.3 divided by 3. So we will get this value. Okay. Now calculation related to dead load has been over. Now we will calculate the center of gravity of empty container, which is very simple. Okay, we know that the components of empty container are, okay, so these are the components. Now height of CG of empty container from top of floor slab will be, so I will show you. So this is the components in empty container, like roof slab, then this is the slab, this is the gallery, this is the beam, and these are the wall. So we need to calculate the CG. So we will calculate step by step. We know that roof slab load is 60.1. okay, so we will take the half here, so that will become 0.6 plus this distance 3.3. okay, from here we are calculating 3.3 plus this 0.6. okay, so this will cover the roof slab. Now next is wall. Wall dead load we know 251.4, then the height of wall is 3.3, we will divide it by 2, so we will get from it the center, so divide by 2. Okay, now minus, here I have written minus because the floor slab is below this. Okay, hence I need to minus. 100.2 is the dead load of the floor slab into the, its thickness is 0.2, hence its half will be 0.1. okay, next is gallery. Gallery dead load is 52.3. Again it is minus because it is below the our assumed axis. Okay, this is gallery, which is below, and its thickness is 0.11. we need CG, hence we will divide it by 2. Okay, minus, the only remaining thing is floor beam. So beam load is, we know beam load, 0.4 is the depth. So we will come to this center by dividing this by 2. So we will get this 0.2 and above 0.2. So 0.2 plus 0.2 is 0.4 and it's dead load. Okay, and we will divide it by the weight of empty container which we have calculated here. So we will get 1.18 meter, the center of gravity. Okay, from here. Okay, so height of CG of empty container from the top of footing will be 14 plus 1.18. As you can see, from the top of footing, this is 2 meter and this is 12 meter and above this 1.1 meter. So from this point, it will be 14 plus 1.18, that is 15.18 meter. Now our next job is to find the parameters of spring model. Okay. We know that weight of water is 499.8 kilonewton. Okay, we will convert it to the newton. And then we need the mass. Hence, I will divide this value by 9.81 so that I will get the answer in kg. Okay, we know that depth of water is 3 meter. And inner diameter of the tank is 4.65 meter as per given. So if we take the ratio of H by D, we will get 0.65. And this value is very important because all this value we can get from this factor only. For that, you need to open the code IS-1893 part 2 on page number 4. Which is very simple actually. Here we need MI upon M, MC upon M, all these value we need. You just need to here H by L we have calculated 0.65, here also 0.65. Okay, so this is 0.5. So you just go from here and mark the line and then go to this and take the value. Okay, for every curve similarly. Okay, here also 0.5 0.6, so go then see where it is cutting for every graph. Okay, here I have written all these values where the graph is cutting. Okay, and we know the value of M, that is we have calculated here. So multiply by that factor, so you will get MI, MC. For H, you have H 3 meter. So whatever the factor is there, multiply by 3 in order to get all these parameters, HI, HI star, HC and HC star, which is very simple. You can get it from the graph. Okay. Now we need mass of empty container plus 1/3 mass of staging, which means MS. We will require this while further calculation. So MS will be equal to 502.1 plus 371.3 divided by 3 into 1000 by 9.81. okay, these all these value you have calculated. I think back page, yeah, 502.1. actually you have already calculated this value. You just need to multiply by 1000 and divide by 9.81 in order to get the MS. Okay, we will require here the lateral stiffness of the staging. I will just tell you the definition here. It is defined as force required to be applied at the CG of the tank so as to get corresponding unit deflection. इसका मतलब क्या है कि जो हमने CG find out किया है, वहाँ कितना force लगाने पड़ेगा कि वहाँ deflection, unit deflection हो. Okay. So as per 4.3.1.3, CG of tank is combined CG of empty container plus impulsive mass. However, in this case, CG of tank is taken as CG of empty container. Okay, So this CG is calculated from software analysis, and the value of, stiffness value I have written here, which has been calculated from the software. You can calculate it manually also. Okay, so our next step is calculation of time period. So time period we need to calculate for impulsive mode separately and convective mode separately. Their formulas are different for time period. Okay, so you will need code here. Here you can see the formula on page number 4. The time period for impulsive mode is 2 pi under root mi plus mc divided by ks stiffness, which is calculated using software. So mi is 33,116 plus ms. These values I will show you. Just a minute. So the value of mi we have calculated here, and value of ms we have calculated here. Those value I have put here. One second. Those values I have put here and then divided by this value. This is calculated from the software. Okay, so we will get the t as 0.80 second. Now we will calculate it for convective mode. This formula is available on the next page here. Cc into under root of d upon rho. Okay. So here you need to calculate CC. For that, here is the graph and you need H by L. Okay, H by L is 0.65. So just similarly go and see where it cuts. It cuts at 3.28. So we will get CC as 3.28. D means inside diameter, which is 4.65, and G is 9.81. So we have get here 2.26 second. Okay. Now next is design horizontal seismic coefficient. Okay, Z according to the seismic zone 1, Z is 0.1. I will be 1.5 from table 1. I will show you here. This is the table 1 and we will get I as 1.5. Okay, now for SMRF, R is equal to 2.5. As we know that Ti is 0.80 second, so we need to find out Sa by G. So for that you will need the code. Here they have assumed soft soil sites, soft soil site. Okay, so here 0.8, which is in between this. So 1.67 divided by T. So 1.67 divided by t means 0.8. So you will get Sa by G value as 2.09. Okay, now just put up this value in this equation. You will get AHI. Okay. Our next job is to find design horizontal seismic coefficient for convective mode. Okay. So for convective mode, formula will be the same, but here Sa by G value will be changed, as damping is 0.5% and Tc is we have calculated. I will show you 2.26, as you can see here, 2.26. Okay. So soil site has soft soil, damping is 0.5%, and for 0.5% we need to multiply it by 1.75. so how this value come 0.74? You can see we need to divide this 1.67 divided by t. Okay, so you will get this 0.74, and you need to multiply it by 1.75 as per the codal provision. So we will get it 1.3. okay, and just put these values, you will get the AHC, means design horizontal seismic coefficient for convective mode. Next point is calculation of the base shear. Base shear at the bottom of staging in impulsive mode. Okay, so the formula is AHI into MI plus MS into G, which is available at section 4.6.2. Now just put up the values, you will get the base shear. Now similarly, you can get it for convective mode. It is 0.04 into, I will show you the formula for this. The formula is at 4.6.2. So this is the formula. AHC into MC into G. We have written the value of MC here and G value is 9.81. So the base shear is 7 kN. Now the total base shear at the bottom of staging will be V equal to under root of VI square plus VC square. So we will get here 60 kN. Total base shear is about 5% of total seismic weight, which is 1126 kN. It may be noted that this tank is located in seismic zone 2. Okay, so now we need to calculate the base moment. Okay, for that you need to go to the section 4.7.2. There you will get this formula. Okay, we have calculated AHI, which is 0.06 into MI value is 33116 into these values we have calculated in our first page. Okay, HI value, HI star will be 1.92 plus HS, which is equal to 14 plus MS, that is 63,799 into HCG, that is 15.18 into 9.81. That 15.18 is come like I have shown this 14 is the total height and then we add the CG. Okay, so here you will get 924 kN meter. Similarly, we need to do it for convective mode. The formula is available at 4.7.2. Okay, just put up these values that we have already calculated, you will get the overturning moment. And in order to find the total overturning moment at the base, we need to put this value under root and make it square. So final we value get 931 kN meter. As I told you, we need to do analysis for empty tank condition also. The process is same. For empty tank condition, tank will be considered as a single degree of freedom according to section 4.7.4. Okay, so first we will calculate the time period. The time period for impulsive mode will be 2 pi under root of ms upon ks. Okay, by the putting the value we will get t equal to 0.65. empty tank will not have convective mode. Okay, so our job will be 50% only. Now, design horizontal seismic coefficient. We know this formula. We know Z value is 0.1, I value 1.5, R value 2.5, and SA by G value for this mode is 2.5. Just put up the value and you will get AHI, which is 0.08. Now calculate the base shear by putting the values AHI equal to 0.08 into MS 63,799 into G 9.81. We will get base shear 50 kN. And total base moment MI star equal to, this formula is available at 4.7.3. Okay, so 0.08 we just have calculated. We know MS, we know height of CG, and we know 9.81 is the G. So total we will get 760 kN meter. So total base shear is 60 kN and base moment is 931 kN meter for tank full condition, and total base shear 50 kN and base moment is 760 for tank in empty. So we need to design, or design will be governed by tank in full condition. Okay, that's it from our today's video. I hope you like the video. Thanks for watching. You can check our description box. Other videos will be there. Okay, thank you.